You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word, spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Thursday, the 7th of July, 2022, 14th week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Brother Elijah Lowole, a Salesian of Don Bosco, studying in Nairobi, Kenya, whose birthday was 2 days ago, texts for us the first reading. Mofu Muhongo from Kitwe, Zambia, whose birthday was yesterday, text for us the responsorial psalm, and proclaiming the gospel is Father Celestine Chishimba, the Dean of the Anglican Cathedral in Gaborone, Botswana, as he celebrates his birthday today. Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. My heart recoils within me. A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Hosea chapter 11. Verses 1 up to 4 and 8c to 9. Thus says the Lord, when Israel was a child, I loved him, and out of Egypt I called my son. The more I called them, the more they went from me. They kept sacrificing to the Baals and burning incense to idols. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk. I took them up in my arms, but they did not know that I healed them. I led them with cords of compassion, with the bands of love, and I became to them as one who raises an infant to his cheeks. And I bent down to them and fed them. My heart recoils within me. My compassion grows warmer and tender. I will not execute my fierce anger. I will not again destroy Ephraim, for I am God and not man, the Holy One in your midst, and I will not come to destroy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A responsorial psalm taken from Psalm 80, verses 2ac and 3b, and verses 15 to 16. Response is taken from Psalm 80, verses 4b. And the response is, let your face shine on us, Lord, and we shall be saved. Let your face shine on us, Lord, and we shall be saved. O Shepherd of Israel, hear us. Enthroned on the cherubim, shine forth. Rouse up your mighty and come to save us. Let your face shine on us, Lord, and we shall be saved. God of hosts, turn again, we implore. Look down from heaven and see. Visit this vine and protect it, the vine your right hand has planted. the Son of Man you have claimed for yourself. Let your face shine on us, Lord, and we shall be saved.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 7 to 15. At that time, Jesus said to his apostles, "Preach as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse lepers, cast out demons. You received without pay, give without pay. Take no gold, nor silver, nor copper in your belts, no bag for your journey, nor two tunics, nor sandals, nor a staff, for the laborer deserves his food. And whatever town or village you enter, find out who is worthy in it, and stay with him until you depart. As you enter the house, salute it. And if the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it is not worthy, let your peace return to you. And if anyone will not receive you or listen to your words, shake off the dust from your feet as you leave that house or town. Truly, I say to you, it shall be more tolerable on the day of judgment for that land of Sodom and Gomorrah than for that town." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hosea has been presenting to us God as a spouse, a jealous spouse, a jealous husband who has been affected by the unfaithfulness of Israel. In chapter 11 of the passage we read today, we see a change of tone. God becomes the mother, not the husband anymore, but the mother. A mother who has intimate love for a child. God loved Israel so intimately and persistently that he even taught Israel how to walk. When Israel was a child, I loved him. And out of Egypt, I called my son. The more they were called, the more they went away. They kept sacrificing to the Baals and burning offerings to idols. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk. That is the work of a mother. I took them up by their arms, but they did not know that I healed them. I'm the healer. I'm not just a mother. I'm the healer. And in fact, that's the work of a mother. The mother heals the child. The mother improves the immunity of the child. God does that to each one of us. He teaches us how to walk on a true path. He is the one who shows that tenderness to his people. Israel, despite the tenderness of God, is depicted as perpetually spurning God's love. But he cannot stop loving, since God is love. His very nature is love. 1 John chapter 4, verse 8. The people of Israel keep up the depraved ways that bring punishment upon them. It is not God who is punishing them. No, they decide to punish themselves. Look at who God is. He feels it because he has done so much for them. With cords of kindness and the bands of love. He says, "I became to them as one who eases the yoke on their jaws. And I bent down to them and fed them. I am that mother to them. Now my heart recoils within me. My compassion grows warm and tender." That's our God. I love him. His compassion grows warm and tender for you and me. Despite your drunkenness, his compassion grows warm and tender. despite your unfaithfulness in that marriage, His compassion grows warm and tender. Despite your resistance to His grace to transform you, His compassion grows warm and tender. He's not like a human being, for I am God and not man, the Holy One in your midst, and I will not come in wrath. That's a promise of God. He's not coming to destroy our world. We may be experiencing a lot of terrible things in our world today, but God is saying, I'm not coming in wrath. I'm not coming to destroy anybody. I'm not coming to destroy the world. I am coming to mend it. I'm coming to rebuild it. We see this in the gospel passage of today when He sends the 12. He sends them to go and mend the broken world. He sends the 12 to go and proclaim as they go. It is the mission on the road. Proclaim as you go. There's nothing like saying, oh no, I will only get involved in things divine when I get retired, or when I get to 50, or when I get to 60. No. You preach as you go. You may be 15 listening to this word. Don't wait until you're 50. Don't wait until you're 30. Preach as you go. On social media, change the social media platforms to be a place where God's word can be preached. Preach as you go, my brother. Preach as you go, my sister. And we have the fourfold mission entrusted to the apostles. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse lepers, cast out demons. This mission entrusted to the apostles is entrusted to each one of us. We are to heal the sicknesses that are connected to the emotional issues people face, spiritual issues, financial sicknesses, physical sicknesses. It is our task, and we are going to do it concretely by showing love to them. Mostly what the people are looking for is somebody to listen to them. They are looking for a listening ear. You may be in certain confusion in your life, but don't forget the mission entrusted to you to show kindness, to show your gentleness to people who want somebody to listen to them. He tells them to raise the dead who have given up hope. Whoever has no hope is dead. Be somebody who has a task of giving hope to people who have given up hope. Cleanse the lepers. Who are the lepers? All the ostracized, all the rejected, all the people who feel out of place. With your smile, with your welcoming warmth, let everyone feel he or she is somebody. Cast out demons. I've spoken a lot about the various demons we find ourselves in. We have that task of casting out those demons, but we should start with ourselves before we start casting them out from other people. Deal with those demons in you before you are able to deal with the demons in other people. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Thursday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for. This is the air I breathe. This is the